Hey guys, how you doing? Welcome back. David Mathas. Thank you for tuning back into my channel and checking out the video topic for today and for all your support. If you guys are regular subscribers, I really appreciate you guys. If you're new to my channel and you'll enjoy the content, please like, subscribe, and share. I'm a coach, trainer, going back for my master's in exercise science. I'm a former U.S. Army combat medic, and I'm just trying to make a positive difference in the fitness industry moving forward using scientific-based evidence research and trying to help put my clients in the best position to transform their bodies the way they want to in a healthy and efficient way. So I hope you guys get something out of my channel, and thank you for tuning in again. So what I'm going to start today, and this is going to be video number one in a 10-part video series, just short little video talking about the top 10 rules for hypertrophy training, basically adding muscle size to your frame, right? And the reason why I wanted to bring this to you is because my goal for many, many years, I've always been a small guy. And for those of you who know my history a little bit and those that you don't, I did suffer from a very, very near fatal eating disorder many, many years ago. And through my discovery of more efficient, more safe ways to go about my nutrition, my training, and just my overall passion from being an athlete my whole life and wanting to build the most amount of muscle possible while keeping the lowest amount of body fat possible, really drove my passion into learning more about strength training and hypertrophy training and how to go about that in the most effective and efficient way. So if you guys are like me, you've probably spent many, many years kind of just spinning your wheels, right? Thinking you're doing the things necessary, thinking you're training the right way, eating the right way, and you're not getting where you wanted to get to. Well, I hope this video series kind of helps you a little bit with kind of eliminating some of that wasteful information that you've been fed in the past. And this can kind of help you move forward so you can make progress the way you want to make progress. So the probably the most basic, the number one most important rule for hypertrophy training, in my opinion, and I work and know a lot of the top research individuals in this field and have access to their information, research review articles by top people in the industry, and just from my own experience, the number one thing you need to focus on with hypertrophy training is your volume, the amount of work that you do in a given session, right? Now, kind of think of volume in terms of your bank account, right? Well, you want your bank account to grow, right? So what do you gotta do? You gotta put more money in it, right? You gotta work more hours, you gotta put more money into that bank account in order for it to grow. Same thing with your body, guys. You need to work in a range, an intensity range that is specific enough to kind of elicit growth, right? But be able to recover enough to put in enough work during that session in order to stimulate the growth needed for your muscles, right? So what does this mean? This means that this is the typical what you hear bodybuilding type rep range, right? 4 to 5 sets of 8 to 12 reps at an intensity which lies anywhere from about 70 to 80, 85% of your one rep max. Now, some of you guys might not know what your one rep max is, and there are calculators out there on the internet that you can put in. You know, if you know your 10 rep max, your 8 rep, your 5 rep, and it can estimate what kind of what your estimated one rep max would be, and then you could take a percentage off of that and kind of know what weight to work with. But the main key, we'll get into that later on, that has to do with periodization and intensity and everything. But what I really want to talk about in this video is the need for a large work capacity, volume, right? You want to be doing a good amount number of sets with in the 8 to 12 to 15 rep range, right? And you want to be focusing on strong muscle contractions, right? Power lifters and strongman, they're not in a sport where they're trying to maximize overall muscle size, right? They're trying to maximize muscle strength. And this is completely different. Though when you're working in volume, you're not going to be, hypertrophy volume, I should say, you are not going to be necessarily getting as strong as you would be if you were simply training specifically for powerlifting or strongman. But with that being said, a bigger muscle is a stronger muscle, right? I don't know too many people with big muscles that aren't fairly strong. So hypertrophy training does go along with strength training, because if you build a good base, a good volume, you get good muscle size on you. Later on, when you start specifying into more of a strength gaining phase, you're going to have more work capacity to handle heavier loads, right? It's not going to take your body nearly as long as to adapt. You're already going to have some strength buildup. Now, for volume with hypertrophy work, there's many ways to go about that, right? You can be doing more reps, you could be doing more sets, you could be progressively overloading in weight each week. Maybe you only go up 5 pounds every week or every 2 weeks, but over time, that is going to add more volume to your overall workout, right? Volume is reps times sets times weight used. That gives you what your overall tonnage is for that specific workout, right? How much weight you moved. And what you want to see in order to maximize hypertrophy, muscle growth, is you want to see that number increase on a pretty regular basis, right? Now, we'll get into deloading and periodization in another video, but what you need to take away from this video, in my opinion, is you need to be able to work your volume up, right? So say 1 week you start off doing 3 sets of 10 on squats at 135 pounds, right? Well, once you kind of got that down and that's pretty easy for you, you can do a number of things in order to add volume to your training session, right? You can add a 4th set at 10 reps. You can keep it at 3 sets and you can add it to 12 reps. Once you've maximized those, you can increase the weight. You can go up 5 pounds, 10 pounds, depending on how your body is reacting and how your recovery is reacting. So to keep this video kind of short, because these aren't going to be huge explanation videos, I'm just going to try to hit on the main points that you need to know. You need to first focus on building up volume, right? Don't be working at your heaviest weight for 1 rep max. You want to bring that weight down. You want to bring that intensity down. And you want to be able to work and be able to get typical rep ranges like 4 sets of 10, maybe 5 sets of 8, 3 sets of 12, things like that, where you're going to be exposing your body to a large amount of stimulus in order to elicit that muscle growth and size that you're wanting to build. So this is just part one of the 10-part series of the most important rules for hypertrophy training. If you guys got something out of this, please like, subscribe, and share. I really appreciate it. You guys be on the lookout. I'm going to get a new video out each day in this 10-part series, and I hope you guys learn a little something from this. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section below. For any nutrition or training programming, coaching, please contact me, mathasfitness@gmail.com. You can find me on Instagram at mathasfitness or Facebook, just my name, David Mathas, and I also have a coaching page, which is Mathas Fitness. You guys go out there, crush your workout today, go have fun, go do something you love, and please take away from this that volume is key. So let that drive your training if your goal is hypertrophy.